Welcome to yet another session. In today's session, I'm going to teach you how to freely upload or use a free mass upload tool for KDP publishing. So if you are publishing in KDP, I have people like students, some of my students who publish 200 books in a week or 500 books in a week. And some publish even up to 1,000 books in a month, and some do more. So if you are doing this and you're going to use the normal uploads, like typing your keywords, copying them and putting them, it's going to cost you a lot of time. And that's one of the challenges low content and low content publishers faces. So if you don't know the tool, you waste a lot of time typing and doing a lot of things that do not add up to your publishing. But if you know how to like mass upload them, you can be able to do more. So you can automate your publishing process by uploading more books. So within like 10 minutes, you can upload like 20 different books, and just doing that because it's faster and you can do more of that, of the same keywords, because of this you need to use the same keywords. You can use the same keywords, the same descriptions for like a book of 100 copies. All you just need to do is to keep changing the cover pages and some of the titles, but you can just do it. So let's go straight and let's look at how you can, and you are fortunate that you're watching this. So just watch this to the end, and I'm gonna teach you how to do that in a minute. So where's my dashboard? Okay, it's here. So you can see the KDP's normal system is like this, whereby you get to put in your like details, like book title. Let me see, book title, notebook. And you put in your subtitle, like composition notebook, for this composition notebook. I'm just typing it. It might be wrong or right. Composition. Don't judge my typing. Composition notebook for primary school. It's, then you can do the dash. Kindergarten. It's for kindergarten. So you can do that, but you can see that it's taking time for me to do that. And once I come in here, I'm going to put the description, which says that grade, whatever, like description, put in the description. Then I have to come here, type this, put in the backend keywords, copy them, put them here, copy them. It's going to take me like 20 minutes to do one. It's not nice at all. So as my student, and you going to use this and do all these things, it's going to take time. So there's a tool that you can just use readily, do all these things and to get away with it. So I'm going to share with you, it's a plugin, but there are two ways that you can get a plugin. There are two ways. So this is the plugin, it's BookBolt's plugin. That's going to help you to do the mass upload. So it's just, this is the plugin. You can get it by going to Google, by doing BookBolt. Just type in BookBolt. BookBolt plugin. So if you do BookBolt plugin, you're going to like BookBolt Lister. So you can just search like BookBolt Lister. So you're going to find it and just install it. Install it on your system. So when you find it, download it and install it into your Google Chrome. So there are two ways to get this. So I will show you how to get it for free, but you need to pay, right? So normally you're supposed to pay, but you can get it for free and it can be with you forever and without you paying it. So the first way, normally you can get like a BookBolt account, is that you go in for their free trial. So they have a free trial that you can always go into for the BookBolt. So there's a it comes with paid options, but you can get like 3 days free trial. So all you need to do to sign up or to get an account is, and you can see, so this is their pricing. All you need to do to activate their plugin is to get a 3 day free trial. So once you get it for 1 day or 2 days, like you can just get it for free 1 day, sign in, get an account, sign up to the BookBolt plugin, and you end your subscription. As simple as that. But if you also want to feel like you can keep it, $9.99 is not something that is too much. You can keep it for a month and use this for also keywords and other things. But if you don't have that amount, you can just subscribe to it 1 day, sign up to this, because once you sign up to the plugin and you are able to log in, it's going to be there forever. Your account is going to be there always. You can even use this like on different PCs, sign up to sign in and use it anywhere, anytime without even having the subscription again. So you just need to do it once and you are good to go. So now let's go to the plugin and I'll show you how it works. So I've taught you how to get it. Now this is how it works. So this is the plugin. So once you come here, you install it. If you don't see it here, you click on this side, extensions, and you come down. So you can see, if I should click on this, I won't see it on my desktop again. I won't see it here. So if you don't have it here, don't worry. Just go to your extensions and click on this icon. I don't know how it's called, a pin extension. So you see automatically to appear here. So what this does is that it's just going to fill in this keys, all the things that you see here that we are doing, you can pre-fill them in that book vault lister. And once you set a key to it, so once you click on that or just press that key on your keyboard, the saved keyboard key that you are using, it will just fill all these things for you, including the categories. And even when you go to the next page, you still fill it for you. So let me open it and you see. So you click on it, it's going to open it and it's going to be like this. So you can see I've already filled in some of the categories, the title and good days, start with gratitude and all these things, and my name and all that stuff. It's already pre-filled. So once I go to my, like you can see, I've already filled this gratitude journal. I filled this good days, starts with what gratitude, that's the subtitle. I fill my name, I fill in the description. So now what I just need to do is go to my Amazon and click on the key and it will pre-fill all these things. You can see it has pre-filled them. So maybe you may not see it well, but let me just go back for you to see how it is done. So it's just pre-filled. I'm gonna delete all of them again and pre-fill them with you so that you not be confused, and you so that you can also do it. You can also do it and do it well. So I'm gonna fill it with you. Once you open the book ball list, it's like this. So I've added some books that I want to publish. So, but I'm going to do it with you new. So you click on here, add. So once you click on add, this thing appears. So we're just going to pre-fill some books. I get some titles somewhere, pre-fill it and use it. Then now you will see how it works. So the title of our book is, we're going to fill notebook. Then the subtitle is composition. Need to take your time. Composition notebook for kids, adults, perfect gift. So you can use this perfect gift for like just type in anything. Your name, you put in the artist name. Maybe my I'm just going to get a name. I am. That's the first name is I, then the second name is M. Then the description. You just get any text that you want to put in here and you just put it here. So this book is about, it's about my international students who have signed up to my best selling course. That's the description. So thank you. But this should not be your description. I'm just writing something to describe whatever we do. Then the keywords, you put in the keywords that you want, maybe house, school, and that's how I fill my keywords. So I'll do a keyword research too. In one of the videos, you see how I fill up my backend keywords. Enter. Go. And you just fill that. Sorry. Make sure you utilize all this, fill it, and create opportunities, fill it more. Then, sorry, goal, post. Just fill it, fill the backend keywords. Once you fill it, scroll up, you see that you get the descriptions as an Amazon. So maybe you're looking at nonfiction. You go to nonfiction, or you're looking at a juvenile or whatever it is. So you just fill it like that. You used to two categories. Mostly I just pick that any category and I'm done. Then once you come here, you select the size of the book. So once you select the size of the book, which is 6 by 9 inches, that's okay. Then you make it active. You make it active, then you go up here, you scroll up the first site. Here, this is where you select the type of keyword that key that you use. If you are typing the backspace, if you are using the backspace, type in the backspace. If you are using the kill, you can type in kill. So anytime you, so you should select a key that you don't use normally. So I use the backcode key. So anytime I press on the backcode key, it fills up my details on Amazon. It automatically fills that up. So once you do this and you save it, it's going to give you the opportunity for it to be on your computer. So anytime you just click on it, whether you open this or not, and you click or not, it will still fill it up. So let's do save. So we are done with it. So it's going to be like, you can see, and you can add up to like 10 books, more than 10 books, and you keep switching there. All you need to do is to keep switching the one that is active, the one that you are working on, so that you, or you can give all of them different keys, so they use that. So we have our book already done. So let's go back to the KDP system and key it in. So once we type in, so I'm going to just press in the backend key, but the backcode key, and you see that you fill this one up straight. So let's do that and see. You can see it has filled it up straight. And if you go here, you see that this is the book, whatever description we gave to the book subtitle, and this were the things. This book is about my international students who have signed up to my best-selling course. Thank you. So it has filled up the keywords and all those things. So then you move to the next chapter. You save and you move to the next chapter. So when you move to the second chapter, you when you press on that same key on the next page, which is the paper content, it will fill up, it will create a free ISBN number for you. You just press the same key, it will fill it up. It will give you the script size and all that. But the only thing you need to do here is to upload your manuscript from your computer, which or this one is not automatic. You have to do it yourself. And you go here and you upload your cover page that you've already designed, and you upload it here. So I hope this helps you to be able to do more. It will save you time, it will save you resources. The time you use to what? Keep on uploading the same information on your keywords or your notebook titles and stuff. It will change. You need to make it fast. And this is the tool that you can use to do all the work for you. So if you can do this like 10 times, you can publish like 10 books within 1 hour. Instead of going up and pick this, come and put, copy, cut it, come and paste it. No, you just select a key. Let me press the key again. It will prefill all that you have already. You can even close this whilst you are working. So this is how you do use the mass upload tool to upload content onto your KDP to facilitate it. So if you see people doing 100 books a day, or they say I'm doing 50 books a day, they've cut up all the cost in terms of timing. So they use this to be able to create that opportunity. Thank you for your time, and I believe in you. So let's meet. I believe we'll meet in the next session. I appreciate it.